In this lecture, we will cover the instantaneous axis of rotation. Instantaneous axis of rotation. And this is relevant when you have rotational and translational motion, that is a quite complex motion. Let us take a pure rolling where V is equal to R omega. And I want velocity of any point. Suppose I want velocity of this point. There is some point here which is at a distance x from the center, and this is r we know. I want to know what is the velocity of this point. So one way of doing it, I know that this point will have one horizontal velocity because of the center of mass, and then this is the relative velocity, v relative, which is equal to the relative velocity of point P with respect to O is x into omega. X times omega is the relative velocity of this point, say A, with respect to O. So at this point basically, one is this velocity of center of mass. This is the velocity of center of mass, which I write as V, which is R omega. This is the center of mass of the sphere which is doing pure rolling. Then on that, you have this velocity, which is to be added to that, which is X omega. And let this be, I'm trying to show you the importance of this, how easy it makes things. I will first do the difficult, relatively difficult one. This is theta. This angle is theta. So now this point will have the resultant velocity will be vector sum of the velocity of the center of mass. This is velocity of center of mass. V center of mass is nothing but V, which is R omega. This is velocity of center of mass plus relative velocity, which is R omega. Relative velocity of point A with respect to O. Now this angle is given as theta. So this angle is theta. So this angle which V makes, relative velocity makes with the horizontal, is pi by 2 minus theta. So this angle is pi by 2 minus theta is this angle. So let me complete this triangle. And this is your V resultant of this point. So my V resultant is equal to this is square if this is A and this is B. It is A square plus B square, simple trigonometry which you have done. And value of A is how much? Value of A is V plus X omega cos pi by 2 minus theta, means X omega sine theta is A. And how much is B? Is X omega sine pi by 2 minus theta, means X omega cos theta, where theta is this angle which this X is making with the O. So I get VR as equal to omega, I take common, it becomes, here I write in place of V as R omega. And I take omega common, omega comes outside, A square upon B square, it becomes R plus X sine theta whole square plus X cos theta whole square. Now see the relevance of this. Now come back to this triangle. Suppose I join this point with this point of contact. I join this. This triangle is made, and have a look at this triangle. At this triangle, let this distance be some distance alpha, A to this O dash. This be O dash, this is O. This distance is alpha. What is the value of alpha? Alpha will be this square plus this square. And what is this? Alpha will be, say this is capital A and this is capital B, this part. What is capital A? Is A square plus B square under root. And what is A? A is R plus what is this? This part? This is theta, this is x, so this is x sine theta. And this is x cos theta. So A is R plus x sine theta. And B is equal to R cos, B is x cos theta. So my alpha is equal to R plus x sine theta whole square plus x cos theta whole square under root. Just see the similarity. This thing is same. So my VR is nothing, is equal to omega times alpha, where alpha is this distance. And if you see this, this will become perpendicular to the velocity, resultant velocity, because if you see what is this angle, said this angle be phi, and this is with the horizontal. So tan phi is how much? Tan phi is equal to this, which is x omega, and this is cos theta upon this upon this b upon a. It is r plus x sine theta into omega. Omega is getting cancelled. So tan phi is x cos theta plus r plus x sine theta. Here you see what is this angle. Let this angle be phi dash. Tan phi dash is, what is this? X cos theta upon r plus x sine theta. See the similarity. It is same. Means phi dash is equal to phi. Means this angle is phi. And resultant velocity was making phi with the horizontal. So the resultant velocity will make perpendicular angle with this, because it is making angle phi with the horizontal. And this horizontal axis is perpendicular to this. And when the angle is same, it means this resultant vector is perpendicular to the line joining A and O dash. So you see the importance. This resultant velocity V is coming as, VR is coming as omega times the perpendicular distance between point A and point O dash, which is nothing but alpha. It is omega times alpha. So this alpha is basically the distance of this point A from the instantaneous center, because your velocity is omega times, means as if this point is rotating about this instantaneous, at that instant. This is the photograph I have taken. Katak, this is the photograph. At this instant, this omega is about this point, and I get the velocity as omega times this distance. So we can straight away find the velocity of any point in case of the rotational with translational motion by simply multiplying the distance between the instantaneous center. The distance between the instantaneous center with the omega gives you the velocity of that point. And let us see the instantaneous center. Suppose I take a body with where few things are given and few things are not given. Suppose we are given that a body has, at certain point this is the velocity A, and at certain other point this is the velocity VB. We have to locate the instantaneous center. In this case, just draw a perpendicular line from both the points. This is point A, this is point B. Perpendicular line to the velocity. And wherever those lines will intersect, that will be the instantaneous center or instantaneous axis, A instantaneous axis of rotation. And this will be the omega. the distance, if you see this distance, VA would be equal to omega times, if this is O, AO, and VB will be equal to omega times BO. And VA upon AO would be equal to VB upon BO. So this gives you the instantaneous center. Suppose it is given in a different way. If you are given that there are two points falling on the same line, and you are given this is the magnitude of VA, this is the magnitude of VB. Nothing else is given, only the magnitudes are given, and this is of course given. We have to find what is the instantaneous center. As I said, when there are two velocities given for two points, just draw the perpendicular from the points. Perpendicular to the velocity, wherever they intersect, will give you the instantaneous axis of rotation. But here, they intersect, they do not intersect. They are on the same line. The points are falling on the same line, and the velocities are in opposite direction. Here, just join these two points. Sorry. Straight line joining these two points will give you, this is the instantaneous center. And see, if this angle is phi, this angle is phi, tan phi will be equal to VB upon, this is O, this is B upon OB, and tan phi is also equal to VA upon OA. So this is constant, so VB upon OB is equal to VA upon OA. This is constant, and this is nothing but omega. VB is equal to omega times OB, and VA is equal to omega times OA. So if such question is given, when only in a diagram this is given, where is the instantaneous center, you just join the two. This gives you the instantaneous center, and this distance basically gives you the distance of the instantaneous center from point A, and this is from point B. And you see omega is common. This instantaneous center shows at that point of time the body is rotating, the bodies are rotating with respect to this point with omega. So if omega will be same for both the bodies, that is VA is equal to AO into omega, and VB is equal to BO into omega. So VA upon AO is equal to VB upon BO. That is what you have got here, VA upon AO, VB, by joining this because of the property of triangle. And this is nothing but indicator of the angular velocity. Suppose we are given another situation where not only they are on the same line, they also have the velocity in the same direction. Suppose this is A and this is B. This is velocity, not VA, and this is VB. Magnitudes. This is the magnitude of the velocity. This is point A and this is point B. Here you simply join the line like this. And wherever it will cut, this horizontal line will give you the instantaneous center O. And just see the property. If this angle is phi, tan phi will be equal to VA upon OA and will be equal to VB upon OB. And VA is also equal to, if you write in terms of, if I say there is an instantaneous center, if this is instantaneous center for my point A, then VA is omega times OA. And VB is omega times OB, means VA upon OA is equal to VB upon OB, which is correct. And this gives me the division of the velocity by this distance, gives me the value of omega. So these are the different methods of locating the instantaneous center. The main utility of instantaneous center is in case of rotational and translational motion. where you can just merely by joining the line, if this is the rotational motion and this is the velocity of center and this is the point of contact, here you want to know the velocity. Here I want to know what is the velocity. So just join this. If this distance is known, the velocity will be, resultant velocity will be perpendicular to this, and it will be Vr will be omega times this distance, which is alpha. So this is the great utility of instantaneous center in case of the rotational and translational motion.